Hello everybody and welcome once again to Mechanism 110. Now today I'm going to finish off this plastic production. So our first thing we need is another machine, and we need the rotary compressor. So what we need to do is we need to make, let's have a look at what we actually do need to make. We need to make H pellets. So we need to make these HDPE pellets. And for that, we need substrate, which we've made last episode, plus oxygen, which we can, of course, get from the electrolytic separator, plus some liquid ethylene. Now, liquid ethylene is made by condensing ethylene in the rotary condenser. Condensator. Can't spell that. Can't pronounce that today, can I? So let's get on and make that machine. So I'm not sure what we need for it. It will be this one, the rotary condensator. So we need a basic fluid tank and a gas tank. Okay, basic fluid tank's fairly straightforward. Gas tank we also know is fairly straightforward, so they're basically just redstone and iron, and was it dust or was it ingots? And the other one was obsidian. I think it's iron ingots, isn't it? Just in case I get the dust, and we'll probably need some of these. I'm bound to need some of these. In fact, I made some more between episodes because I reckon we need stacks of these enriched alloys. So here we go. So one of those. And one of these. I do have a spare one, but it's probably easier, quicker to make a new one. Energy tablet. I haven't got the gold for that. Six or three. And of course we need then, it was glass I think. So yes, just ordinary glass. So we can make a rotary condenser. Fantastic. And we'll put this rest of the ingredients back in here. We don't need those, I don't think. We generally do need some iron, so let's just take a couple of blocks of iron with us. That'll give me 36 iron, that should be enough. I think that's everything I need for this particular trip. Right. Between episodes, I did check the farm, the wood farm. It was working perfectly. It's just running a little bit slowly. I found my other horse, so I'll just take this one here. Let's go over this side and take the bottom one here, which belongs to this horse here. So I did pick it up good, and we'll just trundle over here. I also built the bridge here, so I can just run across here now. We'll avoid that little hole. I didn't move the marker. I have got some posts ready for this particular horse, so we can get off. And I put a torch on top of it. Shift to jump. Where has he disappeared? Right. You saw that. He just disappeared. This particular horse just seems to disappear. Oh, you'll see I've got a set of cats. Oh, yeah. Went to the jungle and did some cat farming. Caught a few ocelots, three I think, and then bred those. I can hear him, but I can't see him, so I've got an invisible horse. Okay, fine. Not the first time. He will appear again sooner or later. I can't even see him on the mini-map either, so that is strange. There's something over here, but that's just a wolf or a chicken. Right. Now, next episode, next step, we need to condense the gas that's coming out of the rotary condenser. So we've got some ethylene. So what we need to do now is we need to take out of this, we need oxygen coming from here. So we've got oxygen coming down here, so we'll bring oxygen down here, and it looks like I can do it straight. So I'll put the rotary condenser here. We obviously will need power, and we'll better make go to the chest. I sorted these chests out a bit actually. Let's just check what I've got this on. Configurator items, let's just change that to wrench and move it and put it nearer to where I'm working, because this has got everything in it from mechanism. I moved, sorted out the two chests, as I said, and put everything in there. Let's put down the rotary condenser. Oh no, I need the cable first. Right, first things first. So we need some universal cable. That was transporter. It's near the beginning, isn't it? One will do for fine. Okay, let's put the cable down here. And put onto that the rotary condenser. We also need some gas pipes, of course. Pressurized pipes. That one. I'll move this out of the way. I don't need my wrench for progressive automation to start with. So I think all I have to do is put this down. And then we connect it from here to here with the pipe. Like that. Now I don't think that comes out until we configure this. So let's go back to this thing here. So here we've got ethylene here, and what we want to do with this ethylene is we want to pump the as a gas, and it should come out on the dark blue side, but auto eject is off, so let's turn that on. And then you see this has come through in here, and this is actually starting to work, and it's producing liquid ethylene. Great. Now what we wanted to produce was these HDPE pellets, wasn't it? So let's have a look again at those, because I'm not exactly sure how I want to connect these up. Maybe I bring the oxygen straight in to the next pressurized chamber. So let's have a quick look at that one again. So it needs oxygen and liquid ethylene and substrate. So the substrate is going to come out of here. Liquid ethylene is going to come out of here, and the oxygen is going to come down. So well, that makes good sense. I think we can easily put the, you see, the pressurized chambers. Let's put it here. So we need another universal cable. I probably should take a few of these out of here. Basic universal. Let's move this stuff out of the way. I don't need the torches for the time being. So let's put that there. Pressurized pipes here. Logistical transport pipes here, and mechanical pipes here. Right, so jump in there, pick up that piece of sand. So we need the pressurized tubes coming from here like this. I hope that'll work. We'll find out in a minute. And I want to put the next chamber on top of that, so that should be in here. Enrichment, there we go. Pressurized reaction chamber. Let's put it where we don't need the food either for the time being. Here. Like that. And then the substrate can come in. What have we got here? We've got, this is producing liquid. That can come in the back, can't it? So let's put a mechanical pipe down here. So it doesn't connect until I configure this. We need the substrate coming from here. So we need the basic logistical pipes here, like this. We'll connect them up like that. And the oxygen coming in the side here. So let's bring the oxygen back one more space. Like that. Now, where have we got problems here? This one is not producing, not got the right connections. Maybe I cannot. Okay, this one's some energy. This also would like some energy upgrades as well. We'll make sure we've got the energy upgrades in these machines, because we will have energy problems if we don't do this. This one will also want energy upgrades in it. And I've got a feeling this comes out of the side here. So the question is, can I move that one place across? we can try it. With mechanism, you don't generally lose your stuff that you come out of here. So maybe I just pick up this gas pipe here and put this down here, like, where has it gone to? Like that. So therefore, we should be able to get liquid ethylene out of here. So basic mechanical pipes can go on here like that. That connects up nicely. Now let's have a look. Toggle operation, liquid ethylene. Now to get liquid ethylene out of here, what we have to do is we have to configure this. So with the configurator, we want it to be configuring fluids because this is liquid ethylene. So we shift right click this one 3 times. And as you can see, twice, I mean, that then pushed the liquid ethylene into here. So we should have in this RPC now liquid ethylene. So the next thing we need is oxygen coming into here. So this now needs to be configured for gases. So the gases is on the, I think I put it on the wrong side. Yes, it looks like it's the wrong side. I'm back to front, so I've got to reverse everything. So we want shift right click those and make that the input. Yeah, so now the oxygen's now come into that. That's be easier to do this from this side, wouldn't it? And then we need the items to be configured coming in from the side here. So then you see that connects up. And for this one, we need to configure the output. So we need the items coming from the front slot, like that. And we also want auto eject on. And you can see the items going into there. So now we've got substrate coming in, we've got oxygen in, and we've got liquid ethylene. And we are producing HDPE pellets. Fantastic about that. Now the last part of this process is we need to produce sheets. Now to produce sheets, we need the enrichment chamber. That's why I built the enrichment chamber. That's that one. And we can probably put that at the front here, can't we? Like that. Okay, we need to make a bit of space for the universal cables. And put some down here. Like that. So that now gets its power. I also want to make sure this has got the upgrades in it for sound, because as you can hear it, so well you can't. But it makes a high-pitched sort of whining noise, which is rather irritating, so let's just put the mufflers in it. Right, that's working just fine. So we've got oxygen, plenty of oxygen. We haven't got enough ethylene, so we need to make some more of that. Man, we've got a crusher here with nothing in it at the moment. Now we can use any sort of biofuel. Let's just have a look at the other chest. I've probably got some more stuff in the other chest that we can use for that. Not sure. Maybe wood. Let's try a piece of wood, because we got... let's have a look at the uses for wood. See if we can actually precision a sawmill. I haven't built one of those yet. I should do that, actually. And smelting. Alright, I can't use that yet. But we can use the saplings. Well, my invisible horse, I shall have to go and find him another time. In the meantime, we're going to have to walk back. That's very strange, that, actually. I wonder if I get too close to the post or something. But in a few days' time, he will appear again and I'll catch him again. In fact, in the tree farm, I should have a load of biofuel. But for that matter, I should have a load of saplings, but they're all being processed into biofuel. Right, here we go. Good. As you can see, you can't. Let's have a look what's in this chest here. I think the saplings are down the bottom here. Oh no, they're at the top. But they look as though they're all empty. Oh. What have we got in here? So here we've got 4,008, nearly, it's actually nearly full, this basic bin. But this has got 2,700, so maybe we need to upgrade the bin. Where's the bin upgrade? Not that one. Not that one. Not that one. Not that one. Right, she'll have to come back and either make a new bin, whatever, because basically it's using all of that. So what we could do, of course, have to think about this a bit, actually. What I have discovered is that these machines here, if I look at this, look at their power output. So it generates, this is in joules, which turns that to RF. So the output of this maximum is 280. And do the same for the heat generator here, which seems to be, it's jumping around again, whichever way. So its max output is 120, that's probably better there. I'm not quite sure why that's going down so much. And that's max output 280, yes, that's right. So this is twice, a lot more efficient than the heat generator in all terms, but more than twice as much. So I wonder if that's the problem with this. It was getting backed up with wood. I'm not happy about this jumping around like that. Anyway, so biofuel I wanted, didn't I? What have I got here? Let's take a couple of stacks of this. 3, 4. And go up and let's go across to the desert again. I probably could take the other horse. That might disappear as well. In fact, it doesn't. This one doesn't seem to disappear. It's just one of those particular. I think that particular horse just disappears. Let's just take this one anyway. There we go. I built that path with a scuba kit, so a helmet and a scuba tank. Oh look, that's only disappeared. Right, let's just get off this horse here. Oh good, let's get the leads. Let's attach the lead to this horse and bring it to this post here. The bottom will do fine, and do the same with this one. Alright, so now we have our two horses safely tucked away again. I've got a third one somewhere as well, but that's in the jungle. So, I don't need to put any of this because that's the output. Let's put the into here. And you can see that's going through fairly fast. And this is emptying it out. And you can see the substrate going into here fairly quickly as well. Now, what would be good? I'm just wondering how I'm going to do this. Because I think all sides of this are actually in use. And that's working as well, producing liquid ethylene. So it's getting ethylene in, I guess. That's already run out of biofuel. So if we put some more biofuel in here, yes, it's working. So that is connecting directly to this. And this, of course, is producing these HDPE pellets. And the last step I haven't completed, and I want to put in between here and here. Now I want to put in the logistical transporter and reconfigure these machines. Obviously, I have to got the right one. So now we have to configure the outputs to being on the front. I'll shift right click, left click this one. And there we go. So that should now output to here. And this one wants to take the input from the back. So that's the back slot here. So we want that dark red. I'll shift these two off for the time being. And it should, it's not actually giving the items out. So what we'll do with this, Because there aren't many uses for these HDPE pellets. Let's have a look at the uses for that. We can make an HDPE rod and some sheets with the crafting table. With the enrichment chamber, we use 3 to make 1 plastic sheet, so we're getting a large saving. That's why I built the enrichment chamber here. So I guess what I have to do with this is to tell it to go into the right mode. And we want items, that one. And shift that way. Now, is that taking the items out of here? It's saying that's coming in, and that should be working. Let's double check that again. Ah, yes. Always something to forget. Auto eject on. And then you can see it. And I'm not even sure I need to do this, to be honest with you. Let's just turn this. Let's just change that to that and see if it actually auto ejects. Well, it sent all 64 out. Yes, so I saw them come through that time. So that's the process. Now, the next step is to use these. And what I want to do with these, let's have a look at the uses for these, is to make these glow panels. You can have different colors of glow panels. So we've got here, we need just some stained glass. We'll actually make the color of the panel. I think, oh no, it's actually the dye in the middle. So you can have red, green, brown, I guess, yes, blue, lilac, purple, cyan, white, no, light grey, so that's with ash, a light grey dye. Grey dye gives you dark grey panels, and so on and so forth. There's 17 different varieties of these. So we'll make the basic ones to start with, and we can, of course, use this to make the solar neutron activator, which I think is for the something a little bit higher, because this is a lot of elite control circuits, a lot of diamonds involved. Right, so the next thing, we have to go to the nether. Let's put the stuff away I don't need in here. I don't need these, and I don't want anything to do with the mechanism on me. Actually, I should check the energy upgrades on those machines as well. This one has got no energy upgrades in it. Let's put some energy upgrades in there. This one is already upgraded, if I remember rightly. And this one too. And the crusher we don't really care about, but I think that's got all of them in. And this one has got speed as well. So it should make things run faster. And I think that's it in terms of machines. Gas burning generator doesn't have any options. The electrolytic separator should. I need some more energy upgrades for those. I don't have them with any more here, so I'll have to make some more. Never mind. We'll do that another time. Let's take the horse again. I've got my lead. That's right. That's all I need. One lead. What else have I got in here that I probably don't need? I've got an arrow and a sword, that's fine. I've got food, that's fine. I've got two configurators, I'll keep the one with me. And we're going to get the horse and go to the nether. There's actually two nether portals. Oops, they're a bit close together. Let's take the bottom one. It's just over there, picked it up on the horse. And here we go. Actually, there is one thing I could do. Maybe I'll do this before we trundle off to another. We've still got a few minutes left, so. Oops, I've done that. That's the second time I fell into that hole. Right, there's the post over there. Dismount with the shift. Get the lead, connect it up, right. What I want to do, let's have a quick check. What I want to do is have a look at glowstone. Glowstone. And that's chisel. And the only thing we can do with glowstone is the enrichment chamber makes 4. And that's it. Okay, I think that maybe a silk touch is a good idea. So let's quickly go make another obsidian paxel. I think I've got enough down here to make an obsidian paxel. We need 7, we've got 7. We need 2 sets of sticks. 8 sticks, let's use 1 block of wood, I think. I like the Paxel best because it means you don't have to change tools so often, so I need to like that. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to enchant it. As we've got 45 levels of enchantment on me at the moment, nothing else to do with them, I might as well enchant it. Now in here I've got a silk touch enchant book somewhere. Got silk touch and efficiency 4, that's probably a good combination actually. I would like to put mending on it at some stage, but let's get this thing upgraded first of all. If that's the right term for a book, I'll put the silk touch on it 4. 5, so we've got silk touch and efficiency. So that'll be a good tool for the nether. Quick bite to eat. And let's get on with it. Now that I have noticed that there is actually, I built this portal which I can jump into. Right, there's the fortress, but there's plenty of glowstone over here, plenty of lava too, but I've got my jetpack on, I think, so what I'm going to do is to first of all mark this, because last time there was a wolf there as well. Let's just put a marker for the portal here. And purple seems a good colour. I think that's a good colour, yes, let's just save that one. One time I came here I couldn't remember where it was, and I've spent ages, I had to save the game and make a new and find out where it was. Now, there's a ghast. Let's just get my out of the way. I've got a feeling that is above. Oh. I don't have much building materials with me at the moment. It's probably above lava. That's probably a bad place to choose to start with. But this one over here doesn't look like it's above lava. Oh, yes, just look at that. Here we go, some glowstone over here. I should be able to get most of this without losing too much of it. I don't have any magnets available, so that's a slight problem. So this one will be the one, the obsidian paxel with efficiency 4. Like that. And silk touch. Easy to fly around a bit. And one last one. Is there any, have I dropped any more? No, I haven't. Actually, I've got 2 portals marked. Interesting. That is interesting, actually, because the last time I looked at this, I didn't have any on. So let's put the jetpack into hover mode. Too much lava around here. Oh, look. A wither skeleton. I'm sure that one wasn't here last time. And you see I come out at a different portal, but it doesn't matter very much. We can just quickly turn the jetpack back to regular and go to the zombie stream hills. It should be over here somewhere. Oh, there it is, look. A sand mountain, I've called it still. In fact, yes, I do need to go there. There could well be mobs about here because I've lit it up and probably not everywhere. I normally spend quite a lot of time going around putting torches down. There's a skeleton behind me, I can hear him. Of course, as soon as you get to the desert, it's not raining anymore. So, now if I remember that, that was the enrichment chamber, wasn't it? So we got 32 pellets in here, PDF sheets. Let's put one of these in here, and we should get out of this 4 glowstone. Fantastic. So now, what we can do with these, we need some glass as well, don't we? So let's go, now we need to go to the base. And I think I left the other horse there, so I'll take the disappearing horse with us. Got the two, get on the horse, oops. Yeah, that's he's there, the right to get on the horse, and let's go back to base. Between this episode and the next episode, I'm going to move the base into the compound, or at least the machines, because the next stage I want to cover is the upgrading of ore, well, quadrupling of ores. But before I do that, maybe I'm going to make the quantum entangler and set up the digital miner somewhere else. Now, let's just shift. Oh, he's still there. Good. Let's catch him. And I'm going to put the digital miner over by the extreme hills. So down we come down here. I'll put the rest of this glowstone. I'm going to take another one actually, because from that we can make a few lights. So let's just shove this into this one because this will go fast as well. Because this has got all its upgrades in. And what we want to do is to make the, we'll have a look at the uses of this, because there aren't that many uses. A spectral arrow. Ooh. That's supposed to be an ingot, so we actually need the crafting one. So this will make our mirror chisels. I haven't done that one either. I did make some chisels. This is the one we want. So we need some glass panes, that's right. The 8. Oh no, I don't want glass panes. Glass panes. Okay, so now we can make these. We want the white glow panel. That one. So we get 8 glow panels. And they're quite neat. Let's go and take away a few torches here. Make it a bit dark and see if it actually works. I'm not sure if these glow panels work best. Have we got some more torches down here? Or is it all the lava making all the light? I've got a feeling that these actually work best on the seat. No. Yeah, that's sort of worked. I don't know. It's difficult to say whether that's actually working. If I put it on the floor here, you see that's bright. And I'm not sure if these go on the floor or on the ceiling. We'll knock it off. I really need a darker place for that, don't I? Let's just test that with a darker place. Now, where can we go to make a darker place? Somewhere in these caves here is probably a good place to go. At the moment this is all being prepared for slime, so let's just dig out a bit down here. What have I got? I've got this a little bit too slow. Let's take the bronze paxel. Can actually hear lava. I don't think I'm going to be in a lava place. Now, what's probably a good thing to do here is to turn on the F7, which is actually an FT Feed the Beast mod. And let's just put one of these down. Oh yeah, fine. So it's working just fine. It doesn't look as though it's lit, but it is. So that's good. So that's rather nice. Let's just put down a real torch in its place, because I tend to mine with torches. So you get an idea, and we'll save these for something a little bit more valuable. Oops. Let's put another torch down here. Great, so they are working just fine. They just don't look as though they're working. And let's get out of here. I also put some sandstone steps down here so we could actually go find our way out. But I've run out of time for today. But what I'm going to do next is to move the base, as I said, and also set up the start to prepare for the quadrupling of ores. And the first thing we need to do for that is to make... Oh, we've got slime over there. Good, that's what I was looking for. Let me get some little baby slimes, which you can bash with anything, I think. Punch them. It's been needed. Right. Oh. In fact, this was not really a slime chunk as far as I could work it out. I think these two were down below here. So I emptied out this area, but I don't think that's it. So either, where is it now? I've got three markers. With three yellow markers, and I can't see that. Oh, there they are, look. And those were the three corners of the slime chunks that I found. It was quite a neat program, actually. We could do quite a lot with it. So anyway, I won't do that now. I shall see you next time. So until then, bye for now.